Welcome to Total Financial Makeover with Dable and Dejanar. Move from lack or barely enough to abundance. Renting to letting. From struggling to thriving. Blick to living the dream. Totally in control. Your head above the waters. Taking safe and superb financial decisions always.
Whoa! Yes! I don't know why you're laughing. We're back! This is Total Financial Makeover. Thank you for joining us. My name is Debo Adejano, your financial jailbreaker, escape crusader, and the emperor of the Sack Your Landlord Dynasty. If you're watching us for the very first time, welcome. My co-host is Rosemary Okurobo, a.k.a. Real Estate Matter, a.k.a. Rema. Okay? Mm-hmm. And here we discuss things having to do with your personal finance, and how you can be financially freer, you can retire earlier, you can make good investment and things like that. But on the channel, I mean, if you're listening on the radio, fine. On the channel, that's our YouTube channel, Debo Adejano, we discuss other topics. I mean, I find time to discuss real estate, to discuss sales, to discuss entrepreneurship. So what you want to do, okay, is not just to be listening to us via the radio. You actually want to go and do what? Subscribe to the YouTube channel, Debo Adejano TV. Subscribe to the YouTube channel. We have over almost 150 videos, okay? More than 150 videos that you can just binge on and enjoy yourself, because they are very, very interesting and educative topics that we've treated in time past. Yes. So,
you're wondering why we have bottle that has red head.
We have bottle that we've not opened. You're wondering what's happening. Are these people shocking? Well, this is not the type that can shock you anyway. Mm-hmm. But we're having it because we're celebrating. If you watched our last episode, we mentioned it that on our YouTube channel, we achieved the 1,000 subscriber, and we promised that we would celebrate it with you. So this is our way of celebrating it with you. So if we are taking the wine here, you guess what you'll be doing? Be enjoying it on our behalf. Or you just reach out to your own fridge, and then take whatever you have there and enjoy yourself also as you listen to us. And if you're also listening via radio, as you watch us on our YouTube channel, go reach out to something and then enjoy. But for us here, this is how we will celebrate as we have promised. So that you know that when we promise, we don't keep fail. It. Mm-hmm. Yes, we told you we are going to pop something. And this is the something we are popping. It is whatever anybody likes that I can pop. We don't have to pop the one that will make us start talking nonsense on set. Abi, on set. So, thank you very much. Today's topic. What's today's topic?
Yes, as we
get ready.
So today, so today we'll be talking about the seven major areas of personal finance.
Seven major areas of personal finance. Before we get to it, let's pop something. Ooh, I hope this thing will not.
Let me take my food.
Yes, here we go to 1,000 subscribers on YouTube.
Yay!
I hope you heard the sound. Okay, so that's it. Our mug. Well, it's not the usual thing to use mug, but then our mug. Mm-hmm. Okay, Total Financial Makeover. Enjoy. So, we'll be sipping something small. You can enjoy with us as we go on. Seven major areas of personal finance. Right. So, number one, income. Mm. If you have to be mindful of your personal finance, then you have to be mindful of your income. Mm-hmm. Like I tell people, there is this formula that I share in some of our seminars. If you've never attended our Financial Freedom Simplified seminar, you want to subscribe when next it comes on, okay? You want to subscribe and attend for Chikini Money if it is not free, okay? And I share some things. I think it's even free or for very minimal fee. I shared some things regarding personal finance and the equation. That is my equation for financial freedom. And I say to the effect that, look, that you'll be financially free depends on how you apply wisdom. Wisdom is a combination of knowledge and behavior. That is behaving that knowledge, acting out that knowledge, carrying out that knowledge. Okay? How you act wisdom, how you apply wisdom on your income and your expenses. That's it. That's what determines whether you are going to be financially free. So the seven areas we are going to be covering today are just the areas that you have to note and the areas that you have to apply wisdom, more or less, okay, in your income and expenses. So in your income, if you want to be financially free, of course, you have to earn as much as you can. Yes, as much as you can. One of the ways you can earn as much as you can is to have multiple ways of earning. For me, yes, a couple of ways. I sell real estate, like she also says. I'm working somewhere, so I earn salary. I teach, okay, so I earn. I speak, so I earn. I write, so I earn. And I, like I said, I teach. So I teach live courses, in-person courses, and also online courses. So those are ways by which I earn money. I do agency, you know, that's it. Consulting. So I earn money from at least about five or so places. That is what you want to do. If you have a regular job, you're a salary person, can you find other streams of income that will not necessarily disturb your major source of income? Do you understand? But we would rather complement in terms of your income earning. That's one. If you must be financially free, and if you must get your personal finance in order, you have to think about your income.
Yeah. So the next one we'll be talking about is savings. It is very important. It's key to have a little percentage of your income or your daily earning into a particular angle of your savings account, or I don't know how you want to save your money, be it piggy bank. The last time we talked about piggy saving,
yeah.
Or maybe you have a particular account that you set aside to put a particular sum of money, maybe daily or weekly or monthly. It's important to always save, because we don't know what something may happen, or I don't even know how to put it, but I know it's important to save, and you will need money in lump sum when anything occurs or when it's important. So please.
And apart from when anything actually happens, also it's important to save, because look, if you must invest
it
usually starts from saving. You know, it starts from saving your money, because a lot of times the investment you want to make usually it will require more money. So you have to aggregate the money somewhat in a savings account or in a piggy bank, or many other ways that you can save. You can watch some of our past episodes. We've dealt with saving before, and maybe one of these days also we will elaborate more on it, as in many ways and how people can save. I think we will treat that topic sometime soon. But we did something on piggy bank.
Yes.
You want to watch that episode? Yes. This episode here, yes, the video, for those of us watching on YouTube, the video will show right here. We did that on piggy bank. You want to go watch it. I recommend that for you. I also brought my piggy bank here last time to show you and how that is progressing. So savings is very important. Saving is not an end in itself, like I always say. Mm-hmm. It's a means to an end. It will help you meet obligations. It will help you also move, advance towards investment. Yes. And then saving, like we said, helps you move towards investment. So if you must be financially free, and if you must master your personal finance, you must consider the investment angle of things. Do you invest? What do you invest in? Do you know the importance of investing? And do you know the do's and don'ts of investing rightly? I think that's another topic we'll have to deal with some of these days. What to do? Do's and don'ts of investing rightly. For example, a lot of people just invest. They don't know that, hey, it's very, very, you are risking a lot if you are investing in something you don't know about. So the number one rule of investment is never invest in what you don't understand. What you don't know. So go for the knowledge. You may not be the one driving the investment, but at least have basic understanding of what you are putting your money into. Okay, so you need to invest, and you need to invest in things that you understand. Very, very important, because investment helps you to grow your money as the aim of investment. Remember, you're concerned about what you earn. You're going to ensure that you earn much more than from one source. then you are going to save, and then you should invest that money to grow your money also. So it helps you to make your money work for you. That is investment. And one of the key that we also share regarding investment is whenever you are investing, what makes sense is that the returns of your, the aggregate returns on your investment should be more than the effect of inflation in the economy that you are based. Okay? Should be more than the effect of inflation or exchange rate. That way, your money, the store of value, the purchasing power of your money is kept intact and you are not challenged. Okay? So that's it.
True. So the next one is financial protection. You need to be financially free and financially protected, importantly. And one of the ways is by insurance. Joining an insurance policy, be it health insurance or life insurance, anyone you feel is important for you, you need to be financially protected.
And it actually goes beyond feelings. It's not about anyone you feel. If you are listening by radio, you see why you have to go to Debo Adejano TV and subscribe. A lot of backlogs that you can catch up on there. So I encourage you, go right to Debo Adejano TV and subscribe. So protect your finance, financial protection by way of insuring, taking insurance on things you should take insurance on, car insurance, you know, health insurance, you know, property insurance, you insure property, so that when eventualities happen, you don't have to take money from your pocket to solve them. And depending on how big they are, they don't have to set you back. A lot of people, emergencies set them back a great deal. You don't want that to be your lot, okay? And beyond one of, so that's one of the ways you protect yourself financially. Another way is to actually save up a special money that you can call, some most people call it emergency fund, right? Most people call it emergency. So save up that money. Usually, to calculate, it's about 3 to 6% of your of what you earn. If you want to know more, and we have a tool that can help you do that, go to Kobo Account. Yes, download Kobo Account. realtypointltd.com/Kobo Account. Go there online, or if you're using Android phone, go to your Google Play Store and download Kobo Account. KOBOCOUNTS. Download it and start using it to help you calculate what your emergency fund is, and you save it up that way. That's the fourth one. So I think we'll go on a very short break, and then we'll be right back to conclude. We have three more to go. And wait, the last one, will surprise you. The seventh one. So I want you to wait for that.
Barcelona Landlord Direct is an initiative of Barcelona Real Estate Cooperative Multipurpose Society Limited. It is one of the membership routes available to joining the cooperative.
On this platform, carefully curated real estate rental income projects and others are offered to low-budget real estate investors like you and I to participate and enjoy the return available with as low as 25,000 naira. You can actually secure a fractional slot of investment on offer and proceed to enjoy real estate return as prescribed.
Everything that needs to be done can be done on the platform, including paying for your fractional slot via PayStart Payment Limited. Investors can pick the pay later option while filling out their investment on this platform.
You actually don't need $1 million to invest in real estate when it comes to the Besama Landlord Direct platform.
You've heard it all from Chrissy and Lekon. That is exactly how Brefi Brown. Enjoy the platform. Go ahead and start investing. You stand a good chance. Let's make real estate money together. Welcome. Yes, it's better. It's better that the camera caught her drinking this. And people watching, listening to us via radio, she was caught in the Zoom. She was drinking. Because in the first segment, I was looking like the drunkard here. I drank this thing about twice or so. She didn't even touch it at all. Not knowing that she was waiting for the break to just quickly sip it. But the camera caught her. And I announced it to those who are on radio. So I'm not the only one that is drinking. Of course, it cannot shock anyway. But then don't make me look like the drunkard here.
So please, the adverts.
Welcome back.
So the adverts, the 25,000 naira advert investment is something you won't want to miss. Is, I don't know how to express it, but it's a great opportunity for you to own your, it's as if you are owning your own rent, because you'll be getting rental income, and at the end of the year or after
5 years,
you get 50% of the money you have invested. Imagine collecting rent when you don't even build anything. That's something you won't want to miss. So if you want more information on that investment and to know how the investment works, these are the numbers to call. You can call Ben's 080-9695-7658 or call Vivian on 080-8582-3975.
Yeah, the money quote of the day. Go to the money quote. What
the
do we
money
have?
Quote for the day is, don't let your learning lead to knowledge. Let your learning lead to action.
Boom.
By Jim Rohn.
Don't let your learning lead to knowledge. Let your learning lead to action. Because you just have constipation. You know too much. And you are not acting on it. Of what use is that to anyone? I mean, who does that? So, guys, the things we are sharing here, guess how it will benefit you? By putting it to action.
Yeah.
The things you are going to be watching on our YouTube channel, Debadiyan TV, guess how it will help you? By putting it to action. Okay. That's what Jim Rohn is telling us there.
Yeah.
Don't let your learning lead to knowledge.
Mm-hmm.
Let it lead to action. So it shouldn't just stop at the fact that you know. So what? Put it to use. That's how it will benefit you and benefit others around you. So we come back to what we're talking about. This fifth, right?
The fifth point
is tax planning. Okay? Tax planning and tax savings. Tax planning and tax savings. That's one other thing you have to be mindful of in terms of your personal finance if you will be financially free. You have to be mindful of your tax, okay? There are things you do. There are ways you plan out your expenses. There are ways you structure your finance, your account, your income, your financial dealings. That helps you to save taxes, to pay less taxes. We are not saying you should avoid tax. We are not saying you should evade tax. Let's put it that way. We're not saying you should evade tax. We're saying that, look, you can avoid paying unnecessary tax by planning yourself better, by positioning your transactions in some way, by doing some transactions maybe in your limited liability name, in an entity, in a corporate entity name separate for yourself, and by doing some probably in your personal name or stuff like that. Your tax consultant will be the best to advise you. Sometimes people say, do I have money for tax consultant? Who can hire tax consultant? Guess what? Your accountant in your office, most of you that work in any organization, or you know one accountant or the other, on a friendly level, you can ask them simple questions. Or your human resource person, because they deal with your payees and things like that, you can ask them questions. They have an idea, so they can guide you. But you must be mindful of how much tax you pay. Okay? How much tax you pay. Some countries, you hear them say they are tax havens or no. Okay, it's tax-free. But you see that things are a bit expensive in those places. It's not necessarily tax-free. You're paying for it indirectly, okay? Of course, there are some clans, there are some countries that are tax-free, tax havens, where people... And those are the things you need to discover, especially as your financial level, okay, income or worth grows. So tax planning and tax saving is something that you want to be looking at.
So the second to the last one, I won't say it's the last one, as retirement planning. It is very key to have a retirement plan because you won't be rich forever. The saying is, I get them before, no be.
You won't be rich forever. You mean you won't work forever?
You won't work forever. You can be rich forever. Sorry.
From the time you become rich, you can remain rich.
You can remain
rich. However, it's not easy. It's easier to get to the top than to remain at the top, they say. Okay?
Sure.
So, you want to, one of the ways is by planning for your retirement because you won't want to probably, you won't be able to work forever, is what she's trying to say.
Yes. You won't work forever. So, you need to plan for the future. Plan for when you are old, because I see so many old people still trying to do menial jobs, and they say, in 1990, I had so car, I had the latest. You had it before, but what of now? What did you do then?
Like
to
you
sustain?
Said, I get time before, no be.
I can't even remember.
No be property,
something like that.
I get time before, no be property.
Something like that. So please, we need to always plan for the old age, the old times.
And it doesn't even have to be old age. Who says you can't retire when you are still active and young? Depends on what your target is as far as retirement.
Yes.
Okay, so what's your target net worth at retirement? Do you even know your net worth right now? you know, things like that. Go to cobble count, it will help you calculate those things. You can know what these are, things that you need to have at your fingertips if you must be financially free regarding your personal finance. Very, very important. So I would encourage you, plan for your retirement. One way to start doing that is to know, what do I even need at retirement, or what do I want to be worth at retirement? And then you start to plan and navigate your way towards it. How many years do I have? What are the other things I need to? So that you put things in place so your quality of life at retirement will not just go down, you know, now because you are no longer actively working and actively earning. You must save for those times. You must plan for those times. And there are ways to do that. We've also done some episodes on retirement,
yes,
right?
Yes, we have.
So go again, okay? You can see that we keep coming back to this. Debo Adejano TV. Go to the YouTube channel and subscribe and catch up on all of the previous episodes that we've had. It will benefit you greatly. I tell you that for free. Now, the last one. And I say it's very interesting because sometimes people don't see the link. Okay, they don't think that it relates, but man, it has a lot to do with your personal finance and personal financial well-being. That is your love and relationship. Yes, your life of love and relationships. If you miss it in relating with people, if you are not a good or a relational person, it will show, and your finance will suffer for it, really. People who can't, have you seen people that are hostile and all of that? Have you seen poor hostile people before?
Yes.
Nobody wants to get near them.
Yes, true.
And then nobody wants to help them in times of need. Mm-hmm. But have you seen very warm, not too well-to-do people before have problems, and people rally around them, they come to support and all of that. You see, you cannot not have money and not also not have manners. It's like double jeopardy. Or not have money, and then you also don't have interpersonal skills. You don't have good relational skills. No. So be mindful of your relationships. Like I used to put it, I've never seen a well-to-do person that does not know so many people. So many people in terms of number and quality. Those two things matter. In terms of number and quality. So, who do you know? You have to add to people you know. I'm not saying make everybody your friend. I'm saying know them to the extent that they can know you. Even if it is just acquaintance. You can always get across to them. Have a system of bringing people, desired people into your life. People of some level of quality, you know. And in some numbers, bring them into your life, attract them. Then, love. Who you marry matter.
True.
If you never marry now, hear me very well. If you are listening to us on radio or you are watching this YouTube channel, if you don't hear Nigerian Pidgin English, who you marry matter. The meaning is that. Can you help them translate? Can you help me translate for them?
The person you are married to is important, or the person you are going to get married to is important.
Or in Queen's English. In it, the person you marry is important. That's not Queen's English, though. That's not Queen's English. Okay, but the person you are married to is very important. It can make or mar your personal finance. That's the truth. You need to talk to spouses that have been wrongly married, as it were, or they've had the misfortune of marrying the wrong person or somebody that is not just ready for marriage. And you need to hear how they've been wrecked financially. So guess what? If you're not married yet, open your eyes very well. It's part of your financial well-being to ensure that you marry right. If you're already married, you don't enter that.
Congrats.
So just, there are ways, if you find out that yourself and your partner are not so financially compatible because of one thing or the other, there are ways that can still be addressed, okay? Expose them to YouTube channel like Debo Adejano TV, where we talk about total financial makeover. Get them to listen to programs like this, okay? Attend seminars on finance and all. Read books. Buy books for them. You know, go with them. Encourage them. Plan your budget together and all of those things. Start to show them how to get some financial sense. If they are not listening, maybe you want to call you want to go to a counselor, okay? It's very important because you're already in it. I won't be the one to tell you to leave the place. No, because guess what? If you leave the place, it doesn't still solve the problem. Who knows who you are going to get married to again? You that could get married to that person. Okay? So, work it out as much as is possible. But if you are not married yet, you want to take that precaution and be sure. of the type of person you're married to. Again, the numbers to call for Brefi, that is to invest, to be a co-owner of a property, like any typical landlord. With just 25,000 naira multiples of it, you can become a co-owner and start to enjoy rent, okay? And when the property is also sold in 5 years' time, you also enjoy the proceeds of sale, just like a typical landlord. The numbers to call, Ben, 080-96-95-7658. And Vivian, 080-85-82-3975. Those are the numbers to call if you want to get to know more about those things that we shared. Your parting shot, Rose.
Please, all these things you are saying now, it's not, how did you wrap it? It's not karamo. I'm glad they put it.
You don't even know. I don't know what you are. She wants to be street, but she's not street, you see. This is still sophisticated to be. She's too sophisticated to be street. So, by the way, what I mean, you know,
okay.
If it were we know what to say and how to say. Street, Oshamo.
So, please, I don't know what those words. Please, just take note of the money quote. We said it. We've tried to impart knowledge to you. The next thing is just to carry it out. Take action. Whichever one you feel you are missing out in all these plans we have said, please try and put it into action.
Yeah, those 7 things are very, very important. So take pride, okay, in improving your personal finance. See you next week when we come your way again. I remain yours sincerely, Debo Adejana, your financial jailbreaker, escape crusader, and the emperor of the Cycle Landlord Dynasty. See you some other time. Bye.
Welcome to Total Financial Makeover with Debo Adejana. Move from lack or barely enough to abundance. Renting to letting. From struggling to thriving. Blick to living the dream. Totally in control. Your head above the waters. Taking safe and superb financial decisions always.